Wouldn't you like to know the top question that you should be asking a lender, whether you're trying to buy a house, condo, townhome, or even refi one? We'll talk about that in just a moment. So that'll be helpful to both property owners and buyers. Good day, everybody. Connor McIver, welcome to our daily housingradio.com real estate radio show. We are a local team headquartered in Santa Clarita Valley, serving greater Los Angeles and all of Southern California. We do bring together a daily real estate show. We talk about what matters. Today happens to be our Truth in Lending Thursday show. So we're going to talk about those, the most important question, I believe, to ask a lender. And I'm also going to give you some online resources to be able to be your access point. We'll talk about local inventory, what's going on in all of Southern California with regard to real estate. Thank you so much for tuning in. If you are on Facebook, connect with us, facebook.com/housingradio. Please check that out. If you are a Twitter person, please check us out there as well, @housingradio. If you want the URL for that, of course, it's twitter.com/housingradio. And of course, we do have all of our access points there, housingradio.com. Please check it out. And there you can search and get property valuations. This is the actual multiple listing service, folks. This isn't some kind of a system that was put into play like a real estate syndication website that's going to not show you all of the data. In addition, those mega sites for real estate, they are lacking in having all the permissions. So you will be missing a certain amount of listings on those sites. In addition, they are all about lead generation, so they do generate leads. You will see that being something that's going to happen once you fill out that form. Once you ask the question, you're going to be just nailed by people that have just been sold your personal and private information. One of the things I can't tell you, when you are searching at MLSBest.com or SCVNest.com, you don't have to worry about that, because I am the contact point. So make sure you reach out. All right, so let's talk about interest rates. Already covered the online resources. Let's talk about interest rates, some of the things going on with regard to those. We will first talk about bankrate.com. That's an actual website you can go to check, to basically vet this question that I will have you throw out to the lenders. Now, as you know, with regard to banks, there are or people that loan money. Three main types. You have your mainline banks. We've talked about this on a past show. You're going to have your Bank of America's, Wells Fargo's, Chase's, those types of corporations, those types of industry names within the banking community. So those are mainline banks. The other type of lender out there you have is a credit union, right? You see credit unions. Maybe you're a Los Angeles police officer, so you have the Los Angeles Police Federal Credit Union. If you were a city employee, you have the LA City Credit Union. So there's a lot of those as well. Those are two types. The other type of lender is the mortgage broker. And the mortgage broker brokers loans. So what that means is they can actually pull on some of that money that mainline banks have, use that. And if they're good mortgage brokers, they might actually be able to save you some money just because they bring so many people that need to borrow money to the table of these big banks. So the big bank is going to be even kinder to them. So they might give them extra discounts and say, well, Mr. Mortgage Broker, since you brought us 10 loans last month, we're going to make the next 10 loans you give us even less costly. You can pass that on to the buyers. Then they get to advertise that. It used to be back in the day when my dad was growing up, you never wanted to go to a broker. You would always want to go to the mainline source just for the simple fact that the brokers are going to be charging a commission on everything they do. This isn't the case anymore. It'd be like this. I'm a real estate agent. You are a particular, you know, person out there in the world. You start to go find sellers for me, and you start bringing sellers to me hand over fist. Well, my services, because of the volume, is going to start becoming less and less in some cases, and then I'll be able to offer you something as well. So there's the rub with a mortgage broker. Might be a little bit more nimble as well, because they do have a lot of other sources of money they can pull on. So that's the layout of the lender. So now back to bankrate.com. When we talk about interest rates, and that's something everybody wants to know about, and yes, they do fluctuate week to week to week to week to week. Sometimes they're higher, sometimes they're the same, sometimes they're lower. The big changes don't happen too often. The half a percent, half a point, half a percent. Now, synonymously, if that's even a word, point of percent, same thing. So if you're somebody's talking about a point increase from a 4% rate to a 5% rate, that's 1 point or 1% change, just so you know. So what, this is the question you want to ask. You are a buyer of real estate. You've talked to a lender or lenders. They've given you information on the different types of loan programs out there. If you are a veteran and some of the other fields of study out there, fields of employment, you might be able to pull a loan for nothing. You might not have any kind of down payment requirement. Then you're moving into FHA, it's 3.5% down. Then conventional, it could be 3, 5, 10, 15, 20 or more. Different, lots of different types of loan programs. So then the lender says, okay, your interest rate is going to be 3.63%. It's okay, got it. That's your interest rate. That's what you're going to get. And depending on the length of time this loan is going to take to pay off, it could be 15 years. It could be 30 years. The rate, and pay attention to this, the rate could be fixed or adjustable. Adjustable rate mortgage or ARM, so it could be that. Fixed is where nothing changes over the next 30 years. Nothing changes over the next 15 years. An ARM, adjustable rate mortgage, means you're going to save a little bit on the interest rate, but that rate has the ability to change at some point. Go up, go down, depending on whatever index it happens to be following. ARMs, they're making their way back. A lot of people still don't like them, don't trust them, and think they're dangerous, but they are making their way back. And the way that they're justified in the lending world, before we get on to the question, the way they're justified in the lending world is, well, I mean, realistically, how long are you going to stay in this house? Usually 5 years. That's about what people live in houses for. That being the case, then why not sell it in 5 years and move on? Good question to ask. You really need to sit down with a professional to talk about these things. And I would definitely recommend some of those great lenders out there that we work with. Wonderful people. All you got to do is drop me a line, make a phone call. Go to housingradio.com. My phone number's at the top, 661-400-1720. Ask us who we use and why. Sit down with them and find out what's going on. Here's that question, though, for both sellers and buyers. So I have a 3.63 interest rate you promised me. Why am I paying that interest rate? That's the question. Ask them why. See what they say. It could be the market interest rate. It could be that maybe you're a more difficult person to fit within a particular program because maybe you're higher risk. Maybe your debt-to-income ratio is higher. Maybe your FICO score is at a low point that's just above the minimum requirement for this particular lender to loan you money. Maybe these are reasons. Maybe, and if they respond and say, well, your credit score isn't as good as we like typically, well, then how do you change your credit score? And how much higher does it need to be for you to get a better interest rate? And especially if your interest rate's going to be a point higher, half a point higher than what everybody else is paying. So then the next follow-up question, well, so you're giving me a 4.5% interest rate. Why is that? And they say, well, it's because of your credit profile. What if I changed my credit profile? Then what would my interest rate be? Also, if you go to Bankrate, let me throw this out. Be careful, because while I like the site and it gives you an indication about where the interest rates are, it's not without its fair share of traps. Once you land on the page, you'll see what I'm talking about. You have a lot of information here. What you're looking for is on the right-hand side of the page. It's going to be right under their social media icons. You're going to see their Facebook, Twitter, Google+, RSS feed, and email. Right below that, you're going to see inconspicuous gray box. It's going to have titles inside of it. Inside of the bar at the top, it's going to say compare rates. then it's going to have a few choices, five choices: mortgage, refinance, auto, CDs, checking, savings. Now, there's an intuitive component probably built in to this website, and it's going to be reflective of maybe what you've been searching for lately online, whatever this happens to open on as far as one of these: mortgage, refinance, auto, CDs, checking, savings, whichever field opens up. Today when I logged onto it, it popped open, it loaded with the refinance number showing. So make sure it's mortgage. If you are looking to get a new loan on a home, used home, new home, whatever, but you're looking to start a brand new loan at a particular address within residential real estate, then you're going to want to click on the mortgage button. So make sure that field is highlighted in blue. And then you're going to see the interest rates. 30-year fixed this week, 3.63%. That interest rate did reduce 0.08, and last week it was 3.71. You can get a good idea. These are going to be pretty close to the rates you're going to be paying with the people out there that are loaning money. If they're way off of this number, ask that question. That's probably going to be the most important for any of you that happen to be wanting to buy your first home, your fifth home. You're going to need to borrow money to do it. To those of you that are wanting to refinance, good question. So that's bankrate.com. I think that's an awesome system. And check it out. Just be careful. All right, so today we have 12,960 properties for sale posted up at scvnest.com. This is the real multiple listing service, scvnest.com. So please go there, check it out. All you have to do is click search and you will be in. As far as Santa Clarita Valley numbers are going this week, no home runs, no big touchdowns are happening out there with regard to our numbers in real estate. And that's indicative of the rest of Southern California. We do have more listings hitting the market. Last 7 days, 90 have entered the resale market. That's going to start to loosen up more and more as we get into spring, and then, of course, into the beginning of summer. So we're going to see some changes on that front. Interest rates are still low, so those of you that also that already own residential real estate, if you're looking to refi, reach out. We're not lenders. We're real estate agents with my team and I. But we would be more than happy to help. Also, a shout out to all those folks that have liked our Facebook page, facebook.com/housingradio. You're awesome. And I also would like to give kudos to those who are going to like it in the future. Everybody have a fantastic day. We will be back tomorrow, Friday finale broadcast. I am Connor McIver. Show number, let me give this to you here. Show number 2016, and I wrote it down. 042-2016-042. That's our show number for today. Everybody have a fantastic day. I am Connor McIver, your host, RE/MAX's Paris 911 team, local agent team headquartered in Santa Clarita Valley, serving greater Los Angeles cities and beyond. Reach out to us when you're ready, and we'll talk to you tomorrow. Check us out at housingradio.com. Connor McIver, over and out.